Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about white clover, also known as Dutch clovers. There are primarily three different types of clovers, but there's like 3,000 different subspecies. All of these species are edible and good for you and have different medicinal purposes for the main three. This particular one I'm going to tell you about is white clover though. This is it. Okay. This has been a food source since time immemorial. The dried flowers taste like vanilla. It's very high in protein. The flowers and the seeds, when they are dried and crushed up or ground up, make a wonderful flour and is also used as a spice to put on your food. When it's young, you can eat it just the way it is. The leaves, you can eat at any time. The leaves are tasty when they're young. As it gets older, you want to cook it like spinach. This clover is the main source of honey, produced honey in the world, other than bees, made from this. It's in the legume family, like the beans and peas and such. The leaves can be used in herbal teas for fevers, colds, coughs, and leucorrhea. Flowers in tea to treat gout and rheumatism has been an herbal remedy for ages. It has estrogen, isoflavin, genistein for you ladies out there. You guys may not want to drink this though, because you don't need any estrogen. You don't want your boobs growing. Clover grows worldwide except for some parts of the Arctic Circle. It is considered a survival food. And you know, the cows really love it. So if the cows love it, it's gotta be good. So instead of cutting that yard, tell your old lady, we're growing clover and dandelions. Let it grow. Buy sheep. You guys smash that like button down there. Give me a subscription. Wherever it pops up at, feel free to tap that baby. You have a great day.